Hey y'all, it's Miss Barbarato again, and friends. My sweet pups are hanging around, so you might see them pop in and out. But we're going to continue talking about jazz for our last full week in April for Jazz Appreciation Month. This week is going to be a little more interactive, and I want to get you involved in making some jazz music. So before we go any further, I do need to say that we'll be using some household items today. And as always, if we're using items around the house, please make sure that you have the help of your parent and or permission to be using whatever item you are going to use. So last week, we learned that in jazz, improvising is a big deal. And that is when you are just making something up on the spot. And we also learned that when you're doing that while singing, it's called scat singing. Probably the most famous scat singer in jazz, besides Louis Armstrong, is Ella Fitzgerald. And I want to share just a short clip of Ella scatting so you can hear. So the first thing that we're going to try is a little bit of scatting. While I know that may seem scary, it can be simple. So the way we're going to help ourselves is we're going to go ahead and pick out what syllables we want to use in our scat. So I have chosen four, and I want you to choose four. You can write them down on a piece of paper. If you happen to have a whiteboard like this, great. Then you can write those down. So just choose four, and that's what'll get us started. So I chose do, da, bop, ta. Now, when we have our music, we're going to have four beats that we can use. And you can be as creative as you want, but this will help you out to begin with. So first, you might sing do, da, bop, ta, but then you may want to change it. And you can go ahead and write down the next way you want to say those, and you can change them. You don't have to use just four. That's just to keep it simple for you. You can use as many as you want. So the next line that I might say might be bop ta da do. Okay, so I've got those. So when we sing, I might first say do da bop ta, and then I might say bop ta da do. Okay? Now that we have our syllables, let me explain how we're going to ease into the scatting. So I'm going to use my ukulele, and I'm going to just strum our four beats. So we'll have one, two, and so on. And we have our four syllables, two lines that you already have. Mine are do, da, bop, ta, da, do. If you want to do the same I'm doing, or you can try to do your own. But every time I strum, you're going to sing a syllable. So it would be and that's just the two lines that we have, but I've got a little bit longer music for us to scat to. So what we're going to do just to ease ourselves in is to repeat those two lines. Okay, so let's give it a try. Here we go. Now that we've gotten our feet wet, we're going to add some more lines of syllables. So I kept my two original lines and I added two more. So this time I have my two original, and then I added dat, ti, dat, da, da, bop, ti, top, toe. Okay, so those are just some more ideas that you can use when you do this later. And what I'm gonna do is, I've got four lines here, and for the whole little song that we're gonna do, there's gonna be 12 lines that we can say syllables on. So I'm just going to keep this in front of me, and I'm going to maybe repeat each line twice, and then I'm just gonna try and use some of these in a different order without having to write it down. And that's what we wanna get to eventually for when we're scatting. So let's give this a try. See how we do. Do da bop ta bop ta da do. Da ti da da. Bop ti top toe. Do da bop ta. Bop ta da do. Da ti da da. Bop ti top toe. Do da bop ta bop ta da do. Da ti da da da. Bop ti top ti toe. I hope you noticed that I didn't stay on the strict 1, 2, 3, 4 pattern, that near the end when I started improvising my syllables, I also improvised the rhythm as well. And that's what I want us to work to as you try to do this on your own. Here's an example of what I'm talking about, that I'm not trying to play and sing at the same time. So it'll be a clear example of using these syllables and not staying on the 1, 2, 3, 4 rhythm pattern. Okay, now that we've gotten to do a little scatting, let's see if we can improvise using some instruments. I know most of you don't have traditional instruments at home, and so we've been doing pretty good at using some household items to make instruments, like we did with our maracas. So again, that was my disclaimer at the beginning of this video. Please make sure that you have the help of your parents or the permission of your parents to use any household items as an instrument. So I'm going to show you the ones that I've chosen to use. First, I want to say that whatever instruments you choose, like if you wanted to use your maraca, you just need to shake that one. But all of the items I use today need to be tapped. So make sure you can either do it with your finger, or if you've got some pencils or pens laying around, those work great as well. So I'm going to show you. My first item is a little empty glass jar. It was actually a gift. You can see my name on it. And I just liked the way that this sounded. Okay. And then my next item is an old Christmas box. And so I liked, I wanted to try to get a variety of sounds. Okay. And then my next item, zzz, plural, are two tin cans washed out from some vegetables we had for supper. So I just love the tin can effect. I love it. Okay. And one thing I love to do with the tin cans, I guess I should show you here, is that right there. Okay. I'm going to set them here. So I can show you my next item. To get a little deeper sound in the mix, my lovely coffee, very important to Miss Barbarato, but it has a nice deep sound when you tap it. And then the last item I chose is another empty jar. I don't really care for the way it sounds when you tap it like this one, because I have the lid on, it doesn't really have the same effect. But the thing I found that was cool, and that's why if you're able to, you can experiment different ways of tapping it, your items. But on the top there, it makes a really cool sound. So these are my items. Essentially what we've done is we've made a little homemade drum set. Case, because I looked for items that had different sounds, lower, kind of middle, and then my high, this would kind of be my cymbals. So, and I have two pencils, so I can do drum set. I mean, you can just be silly, just have fun, okay? And the thing about doing the instruments and improvising is it's probably a little easier because you don't have to think about words to say. You just have to decide which one you want to tap and your rhythm. But you can do the same thing that we did with the scatting. You can start off just doing one item for four beats and then go to a different one. So you could do 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. And then as you feel comfortable, then you can start to be a little more silly like Miss Barbarato and just hit random things and try to make different rhythms with your instruments. Okay, so just have a little fun with that. And I'm going to show you what I came up with for my improvising with our little homemade drum set. You've had a good time improvising. I hope you're able to use some items around the house to make a little drum set and improvise to our song. What you're going to get now is I'm going to have just the ukulele playing the four strum pattern so that you can practice either the scatting or the instrument playing at an easier level, and then I'm just gonna have a video of just the regular song strumming, and you can practice with that as well. So happy practicing, have a great week. As always, please email me or text me videos of your creations.